Hey guys, this is Vicky. I want to welcome you back to my channel. I want to share with you a small haul that I've done at Dollar Tree and a couple things online. I know it's been a while since I've been on and just been busy with trying to get everything organized in my craft room. That has taken so much time, but I have gotten I've de-stashed a lot of my stamps that I wasn't using. I just got rid of them, and I've got some that I might be selling here on my channel. I might share that with you. And some of them are I got a couple of Peachy Keen and maybe some La La Land stamps. Maybe I'm not sure if I want to keep them or not. So there's just some things that I'm hanging on to that I might sell. But some of the other stuff that I had that I wasn't using as far as stamps, and you know how taste changes over time, and what you bought when you first started out, oh, I gotta have that, you don't have to have it. So I've gotten rid of a lot of that, so my craft room looks a lot better, a lot more organized, and I want to get it painted now, so hopefully I can share that with you down the road. But let me get started. I want to share with you this little small haul that I did at the Dollar Tree. I was looking for clear storage containers. My shelves in my craft room, they're like kitchen cabinets, and they're not very deep. I think they go 10, 11 inches deep, and I needed something a little shorter, lengthwise. So I went looking in there to see if they had any, and they didn't have any. So instead, I picked up a couple of fall things. I saw where people were hauling some of the fall signs, and I'll share that with you. Mine didn't have a whole lot out, but I'll show you. I got some mesh tubing. I didn't go crazy on this because I still have some that's upstairs in my closet where I still need to use some, but I wanted to get some greens. I don't think I had green, so I picked this up for $1, and it's 36 feet. Oops. So I got that, and I got this color here, like an orange. I'm sorry for the crinkling. And then I picked up this brown, and they're all of these packages here are 36 inches, so I got those. I'm thinking about making a wreath, maybe for my mother-in-law, for fall. Some of the ribbon that they had was not really, they didn't have a lot out, or they just been maybe picked over, but this is what I picked up. They had some pumpkins, and I didn't go crazy because I'm trying not to hoard anymore. So I picked up this wired edge ribbon, and it is a 9-foot roll. I picked this up, same 9-foot, and I got this one here. I have some fall ribbon, and if I need more, I know where the dollar store is, or I can go to Hobby Lobby and pick up some there, or Michael's. But I got that, so I picked those up. Oh, and one more. Here's another roll here of ribbon that I got. And if you can see, it's got like pumpkins on it. So I thought that was really cute. And then I picked up these owls. They just had different hats, different buttons on them, but different colors. And these are really cute. They're probably really simple to make. But I thought those would be cute. And I might even doll them up a little bit. But I thought they would look cute maybe sitting in the wreath. So I got those. And they had some scarecrows, but nothing really that popped out at me, but just something small. And I thought these would be perfect to fit into a wreath. So I got those. I got this sign here that says Harvest Blessing. And I like it because these are where you can use something else on the back, or you can use this here or reuse it next year. You know, if it fades or whatever, paint it up, or put paper on it and redo it, you know. So I figured that would be nice, so I got that. maybe put some vinyl lettering, you know, paint it vinyl lettering. And then lastly, I picked up two of these trucks. I thought they were cute. So I got these here, and I thought I could either leave that on there or add some more ribbon or something more decorative to go on this. So I got two of these, and these were only a dollar. So I like that. Can't beat that. And that is it for my Dollar Tree haul. Next, I got a couple things online, and I'll share that with you. Let me get this stuff out of the way. Okay. So, next, I picked up this cute little die. It is from Sizzix, and it's a thinlet, and it's super cute. That's the size of it. And I saw Jill Norwood make some cute Christmas tags with this die. So I thought, she enables me. When she does her Christmas tags, and I see the cute stuff that she makes with it, I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta have that die or that stamp. So I picked this up at scrapbook.com. And it was on sale, like, I can't remember, but it wasn't very expensive. And I didn't see it at my Hobby Lobby, so I thought, when I was last there, I don't remember seeing it. So I went ahead and picked it up from scrapbook.com. And then she had also, Jill, had showcased these cute tags. And it's a metal thinlet, and it's got these tags that you can make all in one passing. So she used a couple of these tags in her Christmas tags that she was making this year. So I got this online. It was on clearance, and so I ordered it from Kimbo's Creation. Kim, she's a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. So I ordered that off of her website, and it got here pretty quick. So I was looking for the matching stamps, but they didn't have them, which that's okay. I'm sure I've got small stamps, Christmas sentiments that I can use on there. So I'll use that. And this can be used for all year, not just Christmas or whatever, but all year. So I got that. And then I remember seeing this at Hobby Lobby, and I didn't pick it up. And I wish I would have, because Jill showed it again, and she made some cute stuff. So I found it on, where did I find it? On somebody's, I think found it on Amazon. And this is what it came with. And I picked these up because she made some cute projects with the gingerbread holding these utensils and this bowl. Oh my gosh. So I went ahead and bought it. but I thought that would be cute, even just to have for all the time. And then she also had shown this. Like I said, a lot of this I bought was from Jill, from seeing what she made with them. And this is a cute kitchen dress A2 card maker die. And look at how big it is. Get that out of the way. It's pretty big. And this is the size of my hand. Let me see if I can zoom out. I'm sorry for the glare. But it's like the size of my hand. So it's pretty good size. And she made some cute stuff with this, with the spoon, the bow. It was just amazing what she did. So I got that from Frantic Stamper, and they were quick to get this to me too. And some of these dies I would have never thought of purchasing, because I'd like, well, what would I do with them? But after seeing somebody make some cute stuff with them, now I went ahead and I was like, wow, great idea. So I picked these up. And here is another die set that I picked up from the Frantic Stamper, were these bowls. Look at how big. They're pretty good size bowls. You know? So they're good size. And that helps, but this is the picture, and these are the sizes of what they are, and this is by Precision Cutting Dies, and this is from the Frantic Stampers, so I got these. So I couldn't pass these up, so I got these, and now I've got them, I got to get them in their envelopes, and then I'm going to get them set where they need to be in my, the way I store my dies now, so. And then I went to Tuesday Morning to see if I can find anything, and my Tuesday Morning looked ravished. And all I found was this, and this was sitting underneath a pile of paper. And it was this cute little gate for $3.99, normally $9.99. And really, I think it only should have been $2.99 or even $1.99, but look at this. This is what I got. Thought this was cute even to go in as a tag. You could just use this here or whatever, but or on a card like this here. But here are the numbers if you want it. But this is the only Spellbinder die that I saw. Like I said, everything was just kind of picked over, and I hadn't been there in a while, and it's a good thing because I'm trying to save money. I don't need to be spending anymore. I decluttered a lot of my stamps. I probably need to start going through my punches because there's some punches there that I probably will never use, so, and just keep the necessity or the basics, you know, so, but anyway, so I got that. And then, lastly, I picked up, well, my, get these out of the way, my club La La Land Crafts Kit came in, and this is this month's, package. Or the kit, and you get these dies here, these animals, these sayings, and with it being their fifth birthday, this is what they sent, a little goodie, some more goodies. So because I'm a member of this kit or this club, and celebration of their fifth birthday is a thank you gift. This is what they sent. Look at how cute. I love that poodle. They sent these. How sweet is that? How sweet is that? So I got those, and I thought that was just awesome. I wasn't expecting that, but hey, I'll take it. And then, like I said, here are the dies that come with this. You get a balloon, a birthday, and a happy for the package. These are your stamps and your sayings. And then these are the other set of stamps. So, anyway, that's all that I have for my haul. I want to thank you guys for watching, and thank you for my new subscribers. Hope you have a great day, and bye for now.